In the whole evolutionary process, the Mother Earth has played a very big part through her axis. In the same way, in human beings, the axis is the most important. That's the main principle of life we have got, is our axis. We have to stand on our axis. Those who do not stand on their axis, stand more towards the left or towards the life, are capable of complete destruction. Because either they will be destroyed by too much of right side or too much of left side. So our axis has to be properly dealt with. Now those people who do not have a proper axis can have problems of different chakras, of different kind of quality in a person. A person who stretches his axis too much, puts back his head like this, is a person who is very right-sided and creates problem with his ego. And the one who absolutely bends down like a slavish person also is a person who goes towards his destructiveness. Now there's a big problem between these two types of people, one trying to dominate another, and when they start dominating another person, they actually destroy themselves as well as destroy the ones whom they are dominating. One has to understand that what is the best within a human being is his axis. And everybody has an axis, and one must respect the axis of every person. In Sahaj Yoga, I don't know you by your faces so much. I know you by your chakras, by your sushumna. What sort of a sushumna you have? If you have a deep sushumna, I know you as a deep person. If you have a superficial sushumna, I know you as a person with a very superficial type of a sushumna. And even if you make up something by sort of being very nice or good or talking about Sahaj Yoga or knowing too much about Sahaj Yoga and saying things which will baffle normally anyone, as if you are masters of Sahaj Yoga, I know how deep you are. So the depth on the axis is more important than anything else. Your axis has to be very deep. Now you will say that, Mother, the axis is the same as it is. So how can it be deep? So in the axis, as you see, is made in human beings, is like a 3.5 coin paper like thing. And the inside of it is the Brahmanadi. The Brahmanadi is a very, very small little, we can call a very, very hair-like thing, where only a hair-like kundalini can pass through. But when the person is deep, this Brahmanadi is bigger, and all the rest of them, which are coiled into each other, are smaller. While the people who are not deep, they're outside, what you call the foldings, are bigger than the inside small thing. Now such people could be apparently very dynamic, may look very intelligent, may look very smart, may look to be very good looking, or whatever it may be, outwardly. But inwardly they are not deep. Inwardly if they are deep, their whole attitude is beautiful. They are very joy-giving people. They are very joy-giving. And the more, if you meet a person of another kind, he may look joyous, he may try to give you joy, but the joy won't be really that deep. It would be like a joy killing. So it is important for us to make our axis deeper. And that is where we lack the proper assiduity, the proper effort we have to put in. Now, some people have automatically a very deep axis. And some people have very, very, a very constricted type of the axis. This axis has to be grown. Now, when you come for my puja and all that, I do expand it, I agree. But it is a temporary thing. To retain it at that point, one has to work at home, in the collective also, one has to work very much at home with meditation. But it should be done seriously. It should not be just a joke, to be frivolous, to be stupid. That's not the way. It should be done very seriously in the meaning that it is a devoted task you have taken. It's a meditative thing. It's a prayer to God. You can call it, it's a puja to God. It's to be done with that reverence. Because reverence is the key of achievement. If you have no reverence about yourself and no reverence of others, then it cannot be done. But first you must have reverence for your own life. What am I doing with my life? Where am I wasting it? Why should I waste it? Why should I be deep? After all, there must be some purpose of my life. Am I serving my purpose? Am I doing that? All these things, if they pop into your head, then you will understand it's very easy to fight out your ego. Because normally, on small, small things, people fight. I've seen that in Sahaja Yoga also, people fight on things like, it's so useless, absolutely useless. To me, it sounds stupid to even mention the way people fight over small things and quarrel. But a deep person, even if he doesn't speak much, even if he doesn't show off much, even if he doesn't sit in the front line, he expresses himself through his depth because I can work out better through that. So to develop this, one must meditate. Important thing is to meditate every day, every day, every day. You may not eat your food one day, you may not sleep one day, you may not go to your office one day, you may not do anything that you are doing every day, but you must meditate every day. That's an important point to develop the central constricted part into a bigger area. Now, when that happens, that you start developing it, the first thing you will notice about yourself, that you do not care for any comfort. You're not bothered about any material thing. Whatever it is, you are above it. You just don't bother your head. Let it be. You just don't want to put your neck into a thing where you do not belong. You just get out of it and you think that, this is too much for me. I just don't care for it. So your whole attention now moves inward. When the attention starts moving inward, then it expands more. This is the inner part, which is called as the Brahmanadi, and starts expanding and expanding. Now, in small, small things also, say for example, if I have not mentioned somebody and mentioned somebody else, then they feel, why didn't mother mention my name? It's too small a thing that it doesn't matter. As long as you have a deep access, you are with me, I am with you, absolutely one with each other. But these outward things are, she gave a nice sari to another one, she never gave us a sari, she didn't do this, didn't do that. All those things, if it comes to your head, that means absolutely it's true that there is something lacking with it. Or if you try to complain, I went there, I had to go by a bus and I had to stand on this thing, that shows that you are not comforted. This widening comforts you. That's the comforting thing. And that really makes you feel so comfortable in any circumstance, in any position, in any lifestyle. And you do not want to have any other comfort. And this one has to develop through meditative effort. This balance comes through our depth, and that depth has to be improved. Not through just by talking about it, by talking about Sahaja Yoga, but actually seriously doing meditation.